Ballard got to the station early for her shift and walked into a detective bureau she had never seen so crowded so late in the day. Several Dayside detectives were at their desks working phones and computers. Something had happened. She saw her boss, Lieutenant McAdam, standing by one of the detectives and reading over his shoulder as he typed on a keyboard. She walked over. "Lieutenant, what's happening?" McAdams turned around. "Ballard, what are you doing in so early?" "Was going to get an early start. I had some leftover paperwork and wanted to get in before roll call." "Never know what will happen after that." "Paper on what?" "Oh, just some follow-up stuff on the crispy critter we had the other night. Arson wanted the photos I took on my phone, and then they never sent me their report. So I'm asking for that, seeing if they got an ID. What's going on here?" "We had some hillbilly decide to rob the cash pickup at the In-N-Out on Sunset. Dipshit takes off and realizes he can't get out of the parking lot because the drive-thru line's clogging the entrance. He ditches the car and runs up to Hawthorne, where he tries to jack a UPS truck, not knowing the driver's in the back with the packages. The truck takes off. The guy in the back surprises him. They get into a fight for control, and the truck hits three parked cars." "Wow. I'm not done yet." "Then this guy jumps out of the truck and is still going, but now he's got the UPS guy and somebody that was in one of the parked cars running after him. He goes north again, tries to cross Hollywood, and is run over by a TMZ tour bus. You know how much paperwork that this has generated, Ballard? I got four guys running OT, and two are borrowed from Wilshire. So I hope you weren't planning to hit me up for a greenie on your crispy critter, are you?" "A greenie was an overtime request card." "No, Lieutenant. No OT." "Good, because this is going to break the bank, this deployment, and we still have 8 days to go." "Don't worry. You need me to do anything on it." She felt she had to offer, even though she wanted no part of the case. "No, we've got it covered." McAdam said, "You just take care of your crispy critter and whatever else comes up tonight. By the way, nothing on a new partner for you yet. Mr. Darwin Dean at Wilshire says they can continue to take care of Hollywood Division on the nights you're off." "Great," Ballard said, "but I don't mind working alone, Lieutenant. I've got patrol backing me up whenever I need it." She turned away and looked for a desk to use. The one she had been using lately was currently occupied by its Dayside owner. She picked a spot farthest away from the other detective's activity and sat down to work. Ballard wasn't sure how she felt about McAdams's mention of his efforts to team her with a partner. Her last partner had retired 4 months earlier and had been on an extended bereavement leave before that. All told, Ballard had already been working alone for 7 months.